This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to show how to use the technique of completing the square to find the vertex form of a quadratic equation. So let's start out and talk about the two different forms that you might see a quadratic equation in. There's the standard form, and that's written as y equals ax squared plus bx plus c, and the a, b, and c would be numbers, constants. The x would be the variable. The vertex form is going to be y equals a times x minus h squared plus k. What we want to know is how to convert from the standard form to the vertex form. Okay, that's what we're going to learn. Now, before we go right into the technique, one more thing I want to talk about. Over here, I've got a trinomial, x squared plus 10x plus 25, and that equals the binomial squared, x plus 5 squared. I want to talk about the relationship between these two ways that these two forms of the same thing. If I look at the trinomial, x squared plus 10x plus 25, here's some things I see. If I divide the coefficient of the middle term, the 10, if I divide it in half and square it, I get the last term. I get 25. If I just divide it in half, I get the constant, the second term of the binomial, which gets squared. Let's look at another one. I've got x squared minus 6x plus 9. The middle term is minus 6x. The coefficient is negative 6. If I divide that in half, I get negative 3. And if I square negative 3, I get a positive 9. That's the last term. If I want to know what that looks like as a binomial squared, I just take that middle term, that negative 6x, take the coefficient, negative 6, divide it in half to get negative 3. And that gives me the second term, the constant, of my binomial, which gets squared. This works for fractions as well. So if I have x squared plus 4/3 x plus 4/9, which equals x plus 2/3 squared, over my trinomial, the middle term is 4/3 x, so the coefficient is 4/3. If I divide that in half, I get 2/3. When I square 2/3, I get 4/9, which is the last term of the trinomial. If I just take that middle term, take its coefficient, and divide it in half, I get the constant, the second term, of the binomial, x plus 2/3, which is going to be squared. Okay, so bearing all that in mind, here's how we do completing the square. I've got this problem, y equals 2x squared plus 12x plus 3. The first thing I'm going to do is put parentheses around the first two terms, the 2x squared plus 12x. Then I want to factor what I have in parentheses so that the first term, the x squared, just has a coefficient of 1. That means I'm going to rewrite this as y equals 2 times the expression x squared plus 6x, I'm going to leave a little room and close the parentheses, plus 3. And now what I want to do is work inside the parentheses here. I've got what's going to be the first two terms of a trinomial. I've got x squared plus 6x. If I want this trinomial to be a perfect square, I can create that by taking that 6x, taking the coefficient, the 6, dividing it in half, and squaring it. So I'm going to have x squared plus 6x plus 9. That's going to be a perfect square. Now, I've just gone and added a plus 9 inside this parentheses, and I can't just add numbers to an equation and have the equation still balance. So I'm going to have to do something else in a different part of the right side of the equation. I added a 9 inside the parentheses. That 9 is multiplied by the 2 outside the parentheses. So I've really added 18. What I'm going to do at the end of the equation is just subtract 18. Now the equation is still balanced. And now I'll rewrite this with a binomial squared. I'm going to write y equals 2 times, instead of x squared plus 6x plus 9, I'll have the binomial x, and then I want 1 half of the middle coefficient, that'll be 1 half of 6, which is 3, so it's x plus 3 squared. And then I'm going to take that plus 3 and minus 18 at the very end and make that just minus 15. And now I've got the vertex form of what started out as an equation in standard form. Okay, y equals 2 times x plus 3 squared minus 15. Okay, sometimes you're going to end up with fractions that you have to deal with. So let's do a slightly harder one. The approach is going to be exactly the same. I've got y equals 3x squared minus 8x plus 2. I'll put parentheses around the first two terms, and I want to factor out a 3 from this so that my coefficient for the first term is just going to be 1. I'll have y equals 3 times the expression x squared minus, this will be 8 over 3x, I leave some room, close the parentheses, plus 2. And now I want to turn what's inside the parentheses into a perfect square. So I take this minus 8 thirds x, take the coefficient, negative 8 thirds, I divide that in half, that's going to be negative 4 thirds, negative 4 thirds, and when I square that, I get a positive 16 over 9. So this is plus 16 over 9. Now, I've just added something to this right side. I want to subtract something as well. I have 16 over 9, and I've really added 3 times 16 over 9. So let's see what that is. 3 times 16 over 9. I can simplify this down into 16 over 3. So I've added 16 over 3. I want to subtract 16 over 3. Okay? Now, let's turn this into a binomial squared and clean up everything else. So I'm going to have y equals 3 times x. My middle term here is negative 8 thirds x, so the middle coefficient is negative 8 thirds. I just want half of that. That's negative 4 thirds. That's going to be squared. And then I've got this plus 2 minus 16 thirds. So let's figure out what we do with that. Well, 2 equals 6 thirds. And I want 6 thirds minus 16 thirds. So let's see. That's going to be a negative 10 thirds. So this would be minus 10 over 3. So this is going to be the vertex form of my original equation. Y equals 3 times the expression x minus 4 thirds squared minus 10 thirds. Okay, so just to repeat this one time, the basic approach is going to be you take your first two terms, put them in parentheses, factor them so that the coefficient for the first term is just a 1. Then we complete the square inside the parentheses by dividing that second term in half and squaring it. We add that amount. We balance our equation again. And then we clean everything up and end up with the vertex form. Okay? So practice this a few times. It's not that hard once you get the hang of it, but it does require practice. Take care. I'll see you next time.